Hey Psych2Goers, and welcome back to our channel. Thank you all so much for the love and support that you've given us. Your ongoing support has helped us make psychology and mental health more accessible to everyone. Now, let's continue. Have you ever heard of the phrase, "I need to recharge my batteries"? While this phrase isn't meant to be taken literally, it's really just another way of saying that you need time to sit back, relax, and tend to your personal needs. Do you often overwork yourself and push yourself past your limits unintentionally? If so, it's important to be wary of the consequences it can bring. Tiredness is like a cry for help from our body and mind that's trying to tell us there's something wrong. This is why it's important not to neglect or immediately disregard our feelings when first trying to understand them. In this video, we'll help you identify the five types of tiredness you may experience. Number one, social tiredness. Have you ever felt drained or overwhelmed as a result of too much socialization? Whether it's in person or online, you could be dealing with social tiredness, also known as social fatigue. This might especially ring a bell if you're a more introverted person, but this doesn't mean extroverts can't experience social exhaustion either. Social fatigue doesn't necessarily happen when you're around people you don't like. Even after enjoying a long day with friends and family or going to dinner with your significant other, you can still feel worn out and in need of some alone time. Two, physical tiredness. Physical exhaustion is what you might feel after playing a sport or even after mustering up the energy to get out of bed in the morning. Because you feel it in your body, this makes physical tiredness one of the most noticeable and identifiable of its kind, as well as one of the most common. This kind of weariness may also be a result of lack of sleep or a poor diet. When you're physically tired, you feel sore and heavy, and your tiredness will show through yawns, dreary-looking eyes, or sluggish movement. Number three, emotional tiredness. As humans, we have the ability to feel emotions on various complex levels. For instance, a child dropping their ice cream on the sidewalk might not trigger the same measure of emotions as an adult who's lost a loved one. Sadness, hopelessness, and fear are all emotions you'll face throughout life's obstacles, but eventually learn to overcome. Are you dealing with an overwhelming and stressful situation for a long period of time? Such as an emotionally abusive relationship or a toxic friendship. Prolonged stress can cause emotional exhaustion to set in. Emotional tiredness can affect your energy levels as well as the stamina you rely on to check things off your to-do lists. Number four, mental tiredness. Do you ever have one of those days where your mind feels cloudy and you're unable to concentrate? Mental tiredness affects your thinking and behavior, including how you make decisions and your performance at work or school. Even your long-term and short-term memory can be affected. Mental exhaustion is caused by prolonged stress and working yourself past your limits. As a result, this brings about certain behavior changes, such as social withdrawal or neglecting your responsibilities. And number five, burnout. Burnout is a combination of physical, emotional, and mental exhaustion that gradually builds up over time. Being in a state of burnout can make you feel as if everything you do serves no purpose, causing you to question the point of putting effort into work, school, or your personal goals in the first place. Burnout makes it hard to see and enjoy the good things in life because every day feels like a bad day for you. And life's constant demands can put even more weight on your shoulders. Because it creeps up on you over time, it's not easy to pinpoint the start of your burnout. But you'll know when you feel the extreme level of overall exhaustion. Can you relate to any of these five types of tiredness? If so, what do you plan to do about it? Let us know in the comments below. Staying in check with your mental health and well-being is always a priority. And listening to your body and acknowledging any alarming changes regarding yourself and your lifestyle is one way to do so. Please like and share this video if it helped you and you think it could help someone else too. The studies and references are listed in the description below. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and notification bell icon for more Psych2Go videos. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.